What's up, Niggly?
I was trying to get your ass. You ready? What's poppin', little worldie? It's your girl, Jay Jewel.
It's your motherfucker boy Diesel, nigga, back again. Man. Now we fucking rockin', nigga.
Y'all knew we had to come back ASAP because we had some drop today. We heard about some drop. What came out, nigga?
Your favorite, Nicki Minaj.
My fave. Look at you. How you gonna put that on me like that, though?
You ain't part of the, you ain't a Barbie team?
Okay, so this is what I learned over my break. Uh-huh. I'm a part of what we call the Holy Trinity.
Okay, that's a frat.
Do you know who's included?
Oh, no.
Think about it. We're talking about Nicki, so we know she's in it. Who else you think is in it?
Beyonce.
And?
Cardi B.
Rihanna. It's the Holy Trinity. So that's like a thing. I'm a part of the Holy Trinity.
I ain't never knew you fucked with Rihanna like that.
No, I fuck with Rihanna heavy, but my mom fucked with her so much heavier than me, it seemed like I'd be hating. But I just be like, it's not really all that serious. My mom is like obsessed with Rihanna.
Yeah.
I told my mama she remind me of the lady that killed Selena.
Oh, wow. Oh, shit.
I said, nigga, you would do that to Rihanna.
Shit.
My mama like jealous of Melissa. Like, it's funny. Like, you go deep with this lady. But anyway, we came for Nicki today. So, shout out Nelly on the radio.
Shout out my nigga Nelly.
Dirty. But Nicki and Wayne. So first of all, Wayne just got—he just won his lawsuit against Baby and Universal, right? Or UMG.
Motherfuckers.
Fuck Universal. That's who they were signed to. So we feel like Wayne energy is probably hella lifted right now.
Yeah.
Just cause like that's success. This nigga about to get some M's. Like tens of millions.
That's
of
years.
Dollars.
That's like going to jail for the shit you didn't do.
But it's not even his worth though. Like, he deserves way more money than what the fuck they trying to give him. But
Wayne should be able to retire if he wanted to.
Off of that settlement alone. I feel like he should be getting, like, 200 M's right now. Like, Wayne supposed to be arguably one of the richest rappers ever to exist because of his legacy.
Right.
But, man,
I still feel like Wayne, not to get off topic of the Nicki, but I feel like Wayne, I watched a little bit of his performance at Summer Jam last night, on 7.
Okay.
And he looked happy. So it's just like,
see, that's good. I feel like if we get that energy from him,
That
nigga about to go spaz in somebody's studio.
Cause he raised all these niggas.
Yeah, he's definitely like the father.
You feel me? So
he's the father of not the Holy Trinity, but
right.
Of all this music shit right now. Mm-hmm. Man, let's get into this one.
So this is Nicki's new single from her album that's about to drop.
So before we jump all the way in, I'm gonna say this. Mm-hmm. The title is making me kind of be like, I don't know if I want to hear that between Nicki and Wayne. Like, I feel like we've had that whole run of Nicki and Wayne.
Yeah, and they always talked about fucking. You know what I'm saying? So.
And back then it was entertaining because we didn't know what it was. She was talking about the lesbian shit back then. So it was always a question mark. It was a curiosity. Yeah. And it was almost like a, y'all niggas fucking type shit. Like, we didn't know.
Do you really feel like they fucked? Maybe once. He probably stuck it in a little bit. Took it out like, nah, we can't do this.
I ain't gonna lie. I don't think they had sex.
Where?
I have, like, this certain respect for Nicki where I feel like she's calculated and she knows what she's doing. And I don't feel like she a bitch that just got it by chance from fucking a nigga. You know what I mean? Like,
but Wayne ain't just on anybody, nigga.
I know that. But I feel like if Wayne fucks a bitch that he's doing music with, he's probably not going to sign that.
So do you feel like, when she was with Safari, she was fucking other niggas? Because it seemed like the way she's dating, she's trying to date up. She went from Meek Mill. She's like,
I don't think she's fucking. I don't think she was fucking other niggas when she was with Safari. Because that was the same time she was kicking that lesbian shit and we didn't know what was going on. I didn't even know she was in a relationship with this nigga at that time.
Word.
So I just feel like it's secrets. It's a book of secrets with Nicki. It's cool though. It's admirable. She can separate her personal life from her entertainment life.
Mm-hmm. Rich Sex. Featuring Wayne. I hope this shit don't sound like 2013.
Production-wise, I don't think it can, but it's almost like you don't know what to expect from Nicki Minaj, though. She kind of like a Beyonce with the production selection. Like, we don't know what it's going to sound like.
What Nicki do you... Coming off of the two records she just dropped, what Nicki do you want to hear?
I don't want to hear what I think this is going to be. Mm-hmm. I want to hear...
You think it's going to sound like truffle butter type shit?
Yeah, I think it's about to sound like a pop record. But I would be so excited if it sounded like some real hip-hop shit.
Yeah.
Like some Nicki Caught a Vibe with this beat. No real idea of what direction she wanted to go in, and she spazzed on that bitch, and they just made it a whole concept, put Wayne on that.
No hook. It's just
spazzing. No, not rap shit. I'm talking about like hip hop, meaning like she genuinely just went in on a vibe. No motive, no idea of what kind of song she wanted to create, but it just came out dope. Like, I want to hear some passion in the record. But I feel like it's gonna be like a pop crossover type singing.
I mean, man, let's get into it, man.
We 5 minutes. Let's roll. Ding, bitches. Oh shit.
It ain't playing.
Run Rich.
That's it?
Breeze.
Yo.
Okay, I feel like hip-hop coming.
Yo.
Yeah.
Hey, yo. I know what these niggas like, and it ain't my charm. I ain't stupid, this 250 on my arm. I like money more than dick, nigga, that's a fact. You think pussy's everything? Well, let's have a chat. Ash out, pussy fat, point me to a rich nigga. Who gon' Rico ace me paying for my money, Mitch, nigga? I'ma help him fuck the checkup, I'ma run the business. If your girl on...
I fuck with it.
The concept, I feel like, will work for Cardi B more, though.
I feel like initially I didn't like it. Like when I heard like the first four bars and got an understanding for what she was talking about specifically, I was like turned off. But she switched it at a point where she spoke from like a different perspective about what she was talking about. She was like, fuck that. I want a rich nigga. Like, it was a little different. Mm-hmm. It feels like it's her identity as to where she is in life. And it's ironic that you just said that. You feel like she's leveling up with every person that she dates.
Yeah.
So I kind of fuck with it. I started getting into it right before you paused it.
Word. All right, so one more question before we get back to this bitch.
Go ahead.
Do women prefer a nigga that's rich or a nigga they can build with?
I prefer a nigga I can build with.
Word.
I don't know what women prefer. I can't speak for women. Mm-hmm. I feel like I don't think like the average female, mm-hmm. at least that's being portrayed as the person that most men want to date.
Yeah.
And I feel like I definitely would never want to date a nigga that's 3,000 times past me in experience, because it's like the gap is too wide. I can't learn. I'm trying to build with a nigga where we can learn and become like a solid foundation.
Word.
I don't want the nigga that already got it, because I feel like I'm gonna
be cheating. He already beat the game.
Yeah, because then he beat me. I don't have experience on his level playing field, so that's not a level playing field for me. I'm not going into that shit. How y'all feel? No facts though. Like, how y'all feel?
Now we sending gifts like if it's Christmas. He said, baby, every day we ballin', I said, Christmas. Driving for a non-stop, cause he don't wanna miss this. I said, don't panic, keep the faith, nigga. Big bitch, sex. If you know your pussy worth a binge truck.
That was hard.
Sex. Don't let homie fuck unless his bands up. Rich sex. Go to DR, get that fat transfer.
Sound like she's schooling.
Rich sex. If you
but
want that broke,
that kind of goes back to what you just said about Cardi B, this would be better for Cardi, because this kind of like the shit that she been preaching, but Cardi's coming from a raunchy perspective. Nicki's coming from a polished
and Cardi coming from the bottom. Nicki's already,
that's almost like on. I'm fucking to get up, but not Nicki like, bitch, let me give you some game. It's different. It's like the game coming from Nicki is on some level up type shit. The game coming from Cardi is like, I'm trying to get my level up type shit. But it's funny because it's representative of where they are in their careers.
Damn, this would be hard if Cardi, if they was cool and Cardi.
This would be hard if Cardi had a surprise verse.
Boy, what?
Hip hop would be fire in this digital age if y'all start dropping shit and not leaving like surprise features not in a print no fucking where.
Yeah.
Nigga,
Kanye,
what?
Kanye, don't even do that.
Right? Nigga, what? But now on the other outlets, they release the features. Like I've seen the features now that the album's been out for a little bit. So, but I've seen that in the past too. Like if there's an unknown singer on a song, they won't always put the feature there. But
that's unknown. We talking about
right. Like, I'm saying, like, if Cardi was to come on this shit and she literally was not, and it's featuring Lil Wayne, so we excited because it's Weezy and then Cardi come on that bitch.
Yeah, that shit would
as well as Wayne.
Niggas like, going crazy.
That's when you bring hip-hop back, man. Where's the passion, people? Fuck. I live for that.
All right, so we about to go to the second verse. You know Wayne coming on. Is Wayne speaking from the rich nigga perspective of how he's fucking these women?
Probably, yeah.
It's gonna be
I thought you meant the rich nigga perspective as in a nigga that Nicki's trying to say that you need to acquire. But you saying from a nigga that's trying to acquire certain bitches because he
a nigga that nigga beat the game already.
Right, yeah, right.
Yeah.
That's it. The fuck we tell her.
He might just come on talking about moving better for it.
Nigga, fuck we tell her.
Classic Wayne.
Nigga, fuck we tell her.
But if he fire.
If you let that broke nigga, fuck we tell her. Rich sex.
Wow.
Yeah, mama says she only fucking on a rich dick. Come in her face and tell her now you looking rich, bitch.
Yeah, he got that bounce though. I feel like this that other energy Wayne though. Rewind that bitch.
I had to.
He got that bounce.
Now you looking rich. If you let that broke nigga fuck,
we tell him. If you let that broke nigga fuck, we tell him. Listen,
fuck it. Lil mama says she only fucking on a rich dick. I come in her face and tell her now you looking rich, bitch. In the other room, or can I get a witness? We can have some rich sex. Can I have no rich kiss?
Put your money where your mouth at, that's some lipstick.
That's
just fuck all the money before we contact. That's some rich shit. Pussy smell like money when I'm down there. That's some rich shit.
Pussy smell like money when I'm down there. That's some Nick shit. Okay. Did he say that?
Sound like it.
Y'all back with that flirting shit, huh? Y'all niggas fucking or nah? Like, but no.
Make kiss or something. He licked her nipple or something.
Shut up.
He had to.
Though, I don't even want to think about that because I know Drake wanted Nicki bad. So it's almost like me seeing them in
Drake probably was trying to beg for the pussy too.
He seemed like a begging ass nigga.
But when Drake probably got that power, she probably gave Drake some pussy.
Nah. Drake still lame. Like, it don't change. Like, man. I know you, nigga, from before we was both bobbing. Like, nah. But, Wayne's fast, nigga. What the fuck?
Yeah. Wayne definitely did that.
This sound like that Wayne.
It felt like it was one take, too.
That's, well, okay. I've been watching documentaries of Wayne in the studio from, like, squad days.
Yeah.
And even through, like, the dedication mixtapes and stuff. Mm-hmm. He definitely is the nigga that lay down bars, come out, go back in, lay down some more bars. But this sound like that version of Wayne. Which is fire. And I'm sure he continues to do that throughout his career. But you could see the fire and desire in his ear and his eye, like, back when he was creating that shit. Because he'll come out, like, trying to think of some cold shit. And you could see it. He like, nah, that ain't right. Let me get it right. I feel like later in his career, he just started going with whatever came first.
Yeah.
Versus trying to really critique it. This sound like the Wayne that was like, nah, I got to get this shit right. Mm-hmm. I like it. I'm excited. I'm excited for this Wayne.
It's a man in life thing to get another verse or just hook.
I think she got some more shit coming. If you let that broke nigga fuck me, tell him. Let that broke nigga fuck me, tell him. Rich, sex, rich, who? That breaks two. Yeah. Rich, get rich. Come on, verse three all the time. Yeah. Rich, crew. Come on. My bitch, too. Yeah. That took the wave. Me and Tom, so. Yeah. Yeah. She's fast. She in her bag right now. These days where we landing. At Meg.
Queen, where we going again?
To the moon, Alice. Palace.
Yeah, man.
She in her bag, though. She dug deep for this shit. She went back to her old Nicki bag, like, having fun.
Yeah.
I fuck with this. Mm-hmm. I fuck with it, like, 3,000%.
Better than the last two records?
I really do, because this made me feel like I'm in a studio with Nicki Minaj. Like, yeah. I felt her struggle in creating record. Through how she just came from her perspective.
Yeah.
She did come from that Cardi Avenue as far as topic wise.
Yeah.
But she made me feel like it was Nicki Minaj, Onika, that identity of a person speaking from that perspective. Mm-hmm. Then Wayne came on and killed that motherfucker. Then she bought that little back end bridge with that cool flow on it. Yes. Like, I ain't got nothing to prove.
It felt like some classic Young Money.
Yes.
You
but
know what I'm saying? But now.
Evolve.
Yeah.
This is exactly what I remember saying I wanted to hear from Nicki. When we were talking about this whole Cardi B shit before she even dropped her records.
Yeah.
And then when she dropped her records and I'm like, what I want, really? This is exactly what I was talking about. That Young Money shit. That new age Young Money shit. Mm-hmm. They got Mac on the track. Like, that shit was fire to me.
Yeah. What you giving it? It's one scale, nigga.
9.5. I'm up there with it. I feel like it's going to be a good radio song, too. Mm-hmm. The hook got that bounce in it.
Yeah.
If you let that broke nigga fuck, we telling. That's a quotable.
Big facts. Wayne got hella quotables.
High five. Y'all did y'all fucking thing.
I'm gonna get that bitch a 9. I'm gonna get that bitch a 9.
What would have made it a 10 or a 9.5 for you?
Honestly, I gotta just hear it more.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So right now, just on first listen, I'm like, this is a 9.
That's a good first listen rate. I feel like I got deep into it, so I'm able to really give it my final. Mm-hmm. And I really like the beat selection. The beat is exactly what I said I wanted. I wanted to be on some hip-hop shit where it's like you caught a vibe with some shit. Mm-hmm. Shit came out fire. The right nigga was around at the right time. Weezy got his verse. Sealed the deal. Mm-hmm. It sounded like the exact execution of what I described that I wanted to hear.
Yeah.
That bitch damn near 10 for me, but I just feel like she could have came strong in the beginning.
You think she's going to have like a full-length album, like 14 tracks?
I think she has to.
Okay, so right now, the first three is pretty solid.
Yeah, I think that, yeah, it is. And it's not traditional Nicki starting three either. She be coming with some pop shit out the gate. Everything she's dropped has been hip-hop, with the exception of Barbie Teens. It has a brighter sound to it. Mm-hmm. But aside from that bitch is absolutely hip-hop in its essence.
Yeah.
It's Roxanne Shanté, Rock the Bells, LL Cool J, New York.
Facts.
Classic shit.
Facts.
Ooh, nigga, I'm excited.
Yeah.
This is a great tone that she's setting.
Yeah.
Came out with the controversial record. She came out with one controversial record, which was Chun Li.
Yeah.
Barbie Teens was for the Barbies. For the Barbies. And then this shit is like,
it's lucky for all the women.
Evolved hip hop type shit. And it's not like a mature thing either. It's not like where it's like, oh, I'm older now, so this is how I rap now. It's like still fitting in the times.
She
ice picked that bitch.
She had all the chicks talking, yelling, if he broke, bitch, we telling.
Exactly, bitch. We know you fuck the broke nigga. Stop acting like you fuck with ballers. If that's what's important to you. But I'm fucking with it. I'm here for it. This is the type of shit that I be talking about. Like, whenever we did our Remy shit, I feel like I kept saying she don't have an identity to me. I don't have a sense for who she is, et cetera, et cetera. This is the type of shit I'm talking about. Like, I feel like that was Nicki persona and everything throughout the whole record. Like, it wasn't a miss. She stayed consistent to how she felt about the topic, how she delivered it. And I don't feel like Remy do that shit. Not to even compare, but I feel like I got chewed up for saying that shit. And I'm like, it's a drastic difference in how it makes you feel.
Because I feel like
what's being said on
there's two different artists. Because, like, Nicki has proven success. Remy is still trying to prove. She has to, like, solidify herself.
Nah, I think Remy's proven success, but it's just as big as it's going to get for her. Like, she can't really prove nothing more.
As far as solo success?
No, yeah, I feel like she
had
has.
One. Before she went to jail, she had that one.
Nicki. Remy was popping like how Nicki Minaj was popping early in her career. Right. Before she went to jail, she had more than one song though. Right, exactly.
Right, so she had to come back and she's back to reestablish herself. It's hard to.
She's proving herself to the new age. She's not proving herself to anybody before the new age though. Like Remy was solidified. People fuck with Remy Ma.
Right, but think about it. That's two different worlds. Before she went to jail, streaming wasn't. Now she has to reprove herself to this generation.
But that's every artist though.
Yeah, it's different when you're in jail though.
Absolutely. I mean, we agreeing on the fact that she's got to make her way into this modern day. Music industry, like, it's different. Like, nigga, CDs ain't being, like, you know, we know the whole story, but I'm just saying, like, I don't feel like she's trying to prove anything. I just feel like she's trying to get whatever she can that's left. Like, to me, it's over for Remy in a big way. Like, no disrespect to her, I think she's a cool artist. She had hella potential. I just think she never reached her full potential.
No, I feel that, but she don't believe that.
Right, absolutely not.
So right now, I feel like she's trying to, even with the records with Chris Brown, like, she's trying to reach to be like, nah, I gotta prove, I gotta figure this out. What's the formula?
And you see, I feel like it's just trying to get whatever is left. Like, not like I'm retiring and chilling out and I'm just, you know, my last little run, but just like, whatever opportunity I get, I'm gonna take that bitch.
You think you'll ever get to a point like that in your career?
No, hell no. I would hella transition and do something that I know I have a passion for that I can deliver better. Even if it's out of creating music altogether, like, but just relating to whatever I was doing within music. I just feel like I would evolve in different ways. I'm not trying to milk the cow till it's dry. I'm really not. I'm trying to get that bitch while it's running and move on to the next one.
Right.
But I'm mean, always be embedded in the music, though.
Because, I mean, the vibe, Remy Ma ain't pulling from that, like, that type of, I'm just going to get whatever. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, but look how I feel. Look how it's executed. But
it just feels like old school.
It just feel like not her identity. It's not gonna catch. Nobody's catching on to that. People that fuck with Remy Ma, God honest, just observing feedback that I've gotten and just kind of just seeing what demographic of people like her music. It's people that really like hip hop from before this current age and time.
It feels like the industry fuck with her, cause the motherfuckers that were young when she was coming up are now some of the gatekeepers in the industry. So they like, man, I used to be a big fan of you before you went to jail.
I feel like it's on some East Coast shit. That's what I'm going to say. For Remy, right. It's on some East Coast respect shit. And since New York is like the capital of hip-hop music, or like the original place where it birthed and all of that, it's always going to be a place of huge influence in the industry. So because she's in the favor of those people, that works for her.
Yeah. But, and the industry got this thing. They like love motherfuckers that go to jail and come out. They love that shit.
But that's some street shit, too,
though. As soon as a nigga get out of jail, it's like the industry open up to him.
But that's the same as the streets, though. Like, when a nigga go do a bid and he come home, it's like embrace. Niggas like, nigga, yeah, let's get it. So it's kind of the same thing.
It's crazy.
It's almost like you get that respect.
It's like, yeah, we put you away. All right, here's what you get.
Here go a deal.
Shit's crazy.
Here's your graduation gift. Okay, we all the way off. We all the way ventured left. How y'all feel about that Nicki and Wayne shit, man?
Right.
Y'all gotta be catching this vibe because that shit was hard. We probably just need to say nothing else. It's your girl.
It's your boy D.
J2Ls. We out this bitch. You can turn it off, son. I'm tired of doing all the